Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Mike at HiFiInsider.com. Today, we're going to look at the limited edition Sennheiser HD-25 to celebrate Sennheiser's 75th anniversary. It is actually a very interesting buying process. So when you order the HD-25 on Sennheiser's website, it's not a guarantee that you'll get the limited edition unit. They say that there's only a limited supply, so it depends on availability and the time you ordered. So you may or may not get the 75th anniversary. What I have next to it is the older HD-25. This model has been around for a while. This is the professional version. Specifications-wise, they are identical in numbers, but the design is slightly different. So let's look at the limited edition unit first. As you can see here, it's got a very cool retro packaging. You know, pretty nice. And then you have the yellow HD-25. And then you have on the back a little message from Sennheiser, family-owned business since 1945. And this is the 25th anniversary, inspired by the legendary 414, which, let me give you a quick look at the 414. So this is the 414, Sennheiser's legendary headphone. This is actually the original model. The original model was 2,000 ohms. Yes, you heard me right, 2,000 ohms. This was the world's first open back headphone. And this is, of course, the original one made in Germany. As you can see here, this is the 2000 ohm version. And the yellow ear pads were certainly inspired by this guy with the anniversary edition, with the limited edition. So pretty cool. If you like to see more of the 414, let me know in the comments and maybe we'll look into that. And because there were a couple of version of the 414, because it went to a 600 ohm version shortly after the release, and then they had a white one, and then they had a limited edition one, which is a significantly lower impedance. I believe it's like 50 ohms or something like that. So we can look at that if you're interested, because I also have it. So just a quick teaser, let me know in the comments. Back to the HD-25 limited edition. As you can see here, the two Sennheiser, and then on the side here, just a limited edition picture, and then on the bottom here, the serial number and the authenticity sticker, just in case there are counterfeits out there. And then, you know, you get the model number, serial number, and then this is made in Romania. So a lot of newer Sennheiser products, I believe, started last year. Started to be made in Romania rather than Ireland or Germany. So that's kind of interesting that they moved the production. So as you can see, this is the standard packaging. Now again, if you don't have the limited edition one, you will have a black ear pads and not the yellow one. And so let's look aside here. The side tells you it comes with a straight cable, a pair of extra ear pads, and then a quarter inch adapter. And in here are the specifications, which is the same as the standard HD-25, 70 ohms, 120 dB, which is very sensitive. And then here's the frequency response. So, and then on the back, legendary sound, different languages. It tells you about the driver. So the ear pads are removable, of course. And then tells you about, you know, the different versions of the HD-25. So there's a light version, which is single headband. This is not the single, this is the split headband. This is the classic. And then there's a plus version with extra ear pads and extra cable. So let's look at it. Open this guy up. As with all Sennheiser products, there's no plastic wrapping. I think this is probably more environmentally sound and plastic wraps. Here's the extra ear pads. Now they are the same. It comes with the foam inserts as well. So they're not velour ear pads, where my original HD-25 came with a pair of velour ear pads. And then here's the information guide. So here's the start of the show. Give you a slow look at it. This is of course the not real leather. I like the color, the shade of yellow is pretty nice. Definitely the new kind of wiggly design logo here. So this is the split headband, as you can see. So the idea here is that if there's any hot spots on your head for comfort, you can split the headband so you can distribute the pressure better. So here we go, HD-25, 70 ohms. And then this was a DJ headphone, so the left side can swivel, so the DJ can wear just one side. So, pretty neat. The right side does not do that. And then the cable is detachable and it routes all the way into the headband, all the way around, come back down and then on this side. So you can remove it, you can easily change it. Now they moved away from the steel cable. I believe this is copper now. And of course, made in Romania. And then the cable is a right angle cable. The earlier ones didn't have the right angle, and they were quarter inch, I believe. And then this has got the twist on adapter, which is better. So let me know if you want to see the inside of this, but I just want to show you about the steel cable. As you can see here, this is the steel cable version, which is the earlier version. Specifications are the same, comes with extra ear pads, and these are the velour ear pads, so that would actually change the comfort level of the headphone. And everything else is the same specs wise. Then the Sennheiser authenticity sticker, and then this is made in Ireland. So one thing I want to bring up is that you can get different cables for this headphone because it's the same cable design as the HD 600 series. So it's just a 2-pin cable. So what I got here is I got from Drop. I think it's like $30 cable. It's terminated to the 2.5mm balance connection for Estelle and Kern players. So this way, you know, it gives you a little bit more flexibility, better sound quality, of course, through your player using the balanced output. And then you can also get this one, which is the 4.4 Pentacon balanced. But this cable is a little bit longer because it was made for home use. It was made for the HD-660S, but you can buy this separately, of course. Let me know in the comments if you want to see the comparison between the original and then the sound quality between the original versus this limited edition version. I don't think it's going to have a sound difference, but we'll never know until we compare it. Alright everyone, thanks for watching my videos. It's just a quick unboxing of the HD-25 limited edition Sennheiser headphones. And I'll see you guys again in my next video. Bye-bye.